not naturally a great communicator, and still to this day, I get uncomfortable with presentations at work. But over the years, after many mistakes, I've learned that being good at data requires being good at communicating it. In fact, in this Reddit survey, they agree that you cannot become a good data analyst without strong communication skills. But the good news is that communication is a skill that you can learn, and in this video, I'm gonna talk about my top three data communication tips I've learned after creating over 27 dashboards so that you can learn to communicate data more effectively. Tip number one is know your audience and needs. The number one communication tip is knowing your audience. Understanding who will be receiving the data and tailoring your message to their needs is what makes communication effective. So let's say you're building a dashboard to answer the question of how is company sales performing? The first thing I do is ask who is the user and what do they want to know? If the audience is an executive wanting to know high-level numbers quickly of how is sales performing over time, I would use a line graph like this where you can see that steadily the sales performance has been increasing, and it's a simple chart that gives that information quickly and is easy to read for a high-level audience. However, let's say the audience is now a technical team and they want to know the distribution of sales by year. A box and whiskers plot is much better as it shows the distribution of sales performance including the median sales number as well as the lowest and highest sales number per year. It's the same information, but you can see that a non-technical audience may be a bit confused by this and it would require much more explaining, and it's just not a better fit for someone like an executive who just wants to see the numbers quickly. So knowing your audience and needs really dictates how you communicate data, and that leads me to my next tip, which is data storytelling. Data storytelling involves transforming your data analysis into a narrative that communicates the data. It involves knowing the audience, understanding their needs, and being able to communicate a storyline that helps the audience really understand the data. A structure that really helps with data storytelling is the Data Storytelling Arc by Brent Dykes. He explains that it's very much like telling a narrative in a fictional story where you have a beginning, a climax, and an end. The data storytelling arc follows a very similar structure condensed into four sections. The first section is setting and hook. This is where you set the context and the background of the story. The next is rising points. You support the storyline with additional information. And then the aha moment is your finding and insight. Then you end with the solution and next steps, which includes your recommendation and really makes your insights actionable for the audience. So with the problem statement of how is company sales performing, this is how I would tell the story using the data storytelling arc. Step one is setting and hook. This is where I provide the background of the story, and in this case, I would use the same line chart that I used earlier because it tells the story of the company sales have consistently trended upwards from 2014 to 2017 with total highest sales in Q4 2017. There are noticeable peaks in Q4, historically likely due to holiday shopping. The next step is rising points. This is where I answer the why with supporting information. Why was sales the highest in Q4 2017? To answer this question, I'll use the same line graph as before, but I'll break it down by category. This shows me that in terms of product category, technology in red was the highest in Q4 2017, leading the way with 37% of total sales that quarter. The next step is aha moments. This is where I give my findings and insights. Looking at the bar graph to see the subcategories within technology, I see that the new line of multifunction copiers launched in Q3 quickly gained traction, accounting for 29% of all technology sales in Q4. This suggests a strong market demand for the copier product line. The next step is solution and next steps. This is where I answer the so what, where you take your insights and make it into action. The increase in sales in Q4 highlights the effectiveness of the holiday marketing campaign and the success of the new copier product line. To sustain this growth, the company should consider increasing the marketing budget for future holiday seasons and expand the new copier product line. And that's how I would create a narrative around the problem of how is sales performing for a company. Now you may be wondering, what tool am I using to create all these visualizations? And I am using Tableau. Tableau is today's sponsor and they're a visual analytics platform. I'm thrilled to partner with them because they're a leader in business intelligence and data literacy is now an essential skill. In fact, it's a standard requirement for many careers. Whether in consulting or project management, data visualization is a critical skill. And personally for me, knowing Tableau and data visualization were key skills that helped me land my role today as a business intelligence engineer. So equip yourself with essential data skills and unlock new career opportunities by increasing your data literacy today. You can start visiting Tableau's free data skills program page, which includes courses and guides to support your learning journey. Click the link in my description to start upskilling in data today. Now for my next tip, create the right visualization. Data storytelling is less effective when you choose the wrong visualizations. Eva Murray in Forbes says that your design choice can improve ease of understanding. In data visualization, there are a variety of ways in which you can represent data, but some are more effective than others. And let me show you what I mean by choosing effective visualizations. Using the same sales data as before, I created this table which shows the total sales by product. Now compare this table to a bar graph. This bar graph is by no means perfect, but you can immediately see the insights like phones is the highest selling product, whereas fasteners is the lowest selling product without having to read the table. Now compare this bar graph to a pie chart. Pie charts notoriously have a bad reputation because the insights you get from it are pretty limited. Let me show you. Immediately, we lost the insight that phones is the highest selling product, and you really get lost in this wheel of colors, and it's harder to distinguish what the insights are here. So you can see choosing the right visual dramatically increases the effectiveness of your data communication. Please like and subscribe to the channel if you enjoyed it, as I have more data tips coming. And a great next step now that you know how to visualize data is to apply it to projects. Watch my next video on project tips that every data analyst must know. Thank you so much, and I will see you there.